Bienvenue, willkommen, dobre pozdravljats, welcome, welcome everybody to the Eurovision Piano Request Hour, the one day in the year when I mysteriously transform from a BBC correspondent into a, well, sort of a Eurovision cocktail pianist, really. My name's Steve Rosenberg, I'm one of the BBC's Moscow correspondents, and I love the Eurovision Song Contest. I have done since I was a kid, really, and I think I can play every Eurovision Song Contest winning song that there's ever been since 1956, or at least a little bit of every song. A bit weird, I know, but that's my hobby, I think. And I want to hear what your favourite Eurovision winning songs are. Drop me a line right now on the BBC News Facebook page, and I'll try and play your requests. Now, of course, this year's contest, the 2018 Eurovision Song Contest, is taking place in Lisbon, in Portugal. Sadly, we didn't make it to Portugal, although we are kind of in a bit of Portugal, because we are coming to you live from the residence of the Portuguese ambassador to Moscow. He has very kindly opened his doors and his piano so that we can bring you this Eurovision Piano Request Hour. So, without further ado, let's get on with it. Let's see if your requests are coming in. Please send them to the BBC News Facebook page. And I can already see a request from BBC World News. BBC World News. Oh, no. Shall we start with last year's winning song? Yes. Portugal. The reason why the Eurovision this year is in Portugal. Salvador Sobral. It went something like this. That's a little bit of Portugal's winning song. Your requests have started to come in. What's your favourite Eurovision winning song? Aaron Slack says 2004, Finland, Hard Rock Hallelujah. That was 2006, I believe. That's a difficult one to play. I'll try and play a little bit of it. Lordy, they wore masks. I haven't got a mask to wear today. That was a little bit of Hard Rock Hallelujah. Oscar Garcia would like Euphoria. Yes, that was a classic from Sweden, Loreen, in 2012. Thank you. there, a little bit of euphoria. Now, René Auguste would like Waterloo. Of course, ABBA in 1974 for Sweden. That really is a Eurovision classic. Is a classic song. Interestingly, earlier today I spoke to President Putin's press secretary and I asked him whether President Putin was interested in Eurovision, and the press secretary said that Vladimir Putin likes some ABBA songs, but he says he doesn't have much time at the moment to listen to music. Quite interesting. And I'm sure all ABBA fans are excited to hear the news, of course, that there are going to be two new ABBA songs coming out later this year. I think everyone wants to hear them. So on we go. Gina North says, can I play Puppet on a String? That was a winner for the United Kingdom in 1967, I think. Puppet on a String, Sandy Shaw. The song that came second to Puppet on a String in the UK heat to choose a song for Eurovision that year, I think was actually a better song. Let me play you a bit. It was also sung by Sandy Shaw. I think it was called Tell the Boys. It was... Yeah, that was Tell the Boys. That was had almost made it to Eurovision. Let's see. Jane Kay is another fan of Waterloo. I hope you enjoyed Waterloo just now. Marco Jacobs, also a fan of Waterloo. Andrew Cobb, too, like Waterloo. Claire Mitchell would love to hear Johnny Logan, What's Another Year? That was a winner for Ireland in 1980. Thank you. That was Johnny Logan, What's Another Year. Johnny Logan, of course, is the only man to have won the Eurovision Song Contest three times, twice as a performer and once as a songwriter. James Harrison would like Rise Like a Phoenix by Conchita for Austria. Yes, let me play a little bit of that. A little bit of Conchita, Rise Like a Phoenix. Anatta Lopnan also likes Waterloo. Lots of people requesting Waterloo. Anita Wim says, please play Fairy Tale by Alexander Rybak of Norway, the 2009 winner. She says she just loves it. I'll try. Alexander Rybak is taking part in this year's contest too. Here's a little bit of Fairy Tale. A little bit of Fairy Tale. We wish him well this year too. Robert Priestley, can you play Spain's La 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 song? I'll certainly try, Robert. La 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 won 50 years ago. Yeah, 1968 for Spain. Thank you. of La La La. Louise Davis asks, what's the flag in the corner of the room? The Portuguese flag, because we're in the residence of the Portuguese ambassador to Moscow, who's very kindly let us in today. Sally O'Donnell, Mary Hopkins, she says. You mean Knock Knock Who's There, I think, from 1970. Now, it didn't win, it came second, but it was a really lovely song. It was something like... Yeah, that was 1970. That was the year, I think, that Dana won for Ireland with All Kinds of Everything. I'll play you a little bit of that. The winning Eurovision song in 1970, Dana. Let's see. Caroline Suzanne Rose would like Johnny Logan, Hold Me Now, in 1987. She loves that one. I do too, Caroline. It's one of the best Eurovision songs. Here comes Hold Me Now, 1987 for Ireland. Thank you. Johnny Logan, that was a great Eurovision song, I have to say. Let's go on. Ian McClay would like Bucks Fizz, Making Your Mind Up. That was a victory for the United Kingdom back in 1981, I think. A bit of Bucks Fizz from 1981. Ken Murphy says he loves what I'm doing. Thank you very much, Ken. That's very kind of you. He says, I wish I could play the piano now. I wish you could too. Ken, Sean Byrne says, do you know Charlotte Nielsen, Take Me to Your Heaven? That was a victory for Sweden in 1999. Sweden from 1999. On we go. Nicky McLeod would like Nicole, A Little Love, A Little Peace, I think it was called, and that was Germany, 1982. Nicole from 1982. Let's see, what have we got next? Sally O'Donnell would like Love Shine a Light, Katrina and the Waves from 1997. Thank you. That's a bit of Katrina and the Waves. That's the last time the United Kingdom won the Eurovision Song Contest. It's time we won it again, I think. Let's go on. Justine Langham says she wants to hear my favourite song. Well, I've got lots of favourite Eurovision songs because over the 63 years of the contest, there have been so many great melodies. One of my favourites is Un Jour, Un Enfant, which won for France in 1969. That was the year that four countries tied for first place. But I think the French song was the best. It was sung by the late, great Frida Baccara. That was the French winning song from 1969, the year that Boom Bang A Bang won, too, for the United Kingdom. Let's go on. And what have we got next? Lynn Hunter. Do you remember Belgium, 1986? Sandra Kim, J'aime la vie. Let's see. It was... There's a little bit of Belgium, 1986, Sandra Kim, J'aime la vie. David Curran, Fly on the Wings of Love. That was from 2000, a win for Denmark, I think. Danish song from 2000. Jono Godley would love to hear Fairy Tale. We've played that. That was Alexander Rybak. Clive Cooper Ford is asking for Satellite. That was later. That was Germany, and that was 2010, I think. Something like this. Satellite. Let's go on. Mags Mayella, I hope I pronounced your name right, asked for Why Me, sung by Linda Martin, written by Johnny Logan for Ireland. Yes, that's a nice song, that one in 1992, I think, for Ireland. It went something like this. Bit of Why Me, sung by Linda Martin, written by Johnny Logan. Chris Hayes would like Poupée de Cire, Poupée de Sang. That was a winner for Luxembourg in 1965, I think, sung by France Gall, who very sadly passed away this year. This was Poupée de Cire, Poupée de Sang. Poupée de Cire, Poupée de Sang. Interestingly, France Gall, who sung that winning song, inspired one of the greatest popular songs ever written. It was called Comme d'habitude. It was sung by the French singer Claude François, who was the lover of France Gall. He sang about their rocky relationship. English words were then written for that song, and it became a super hit around the world, hit for Frank Sinatra as My Way. Let me just play a little bit in memory of France Gall, the lady who inspired that. there. Not a Eurovision song, but a song inspired by the winner of the 1965 Eurovision Song Contest, Franz Gall. Let's move back to your requests. Archie Bunny, Only Teardrops, Emil Defors. Yes, for Denmark. Denmark, 2015, I think. So, let's go on. Let's see. Namanda Fred, Wawoo, It's Just Amazing. Well, thank you very much indeed. I'm glad you're enjoying it. Laila Avdalova asks, when is the Eurovision? Well, the first semi-final takes place tonight, and the grand final is on Saturday. So I hope you tune in wherever you are. Caroline Longman says she can't say it was her favourite, but wasn't there Pearl Carr and Teddy Johnson, Sing Little Birdie, back in the Stone Age? Yeah, they had Eurovision back in the Stone Age. There was a song, Sing Little Birdie. It didn't win, but it went something like this. Something like that, anyway. That was Sing Little Birdie. I wasn't alive in the Stone Age, believe me. Caris Lamb, can you play Bardo One Step Further? Not a winning song. It was something like... Something like that. I don't know all Eurovision songs. There are more than 1,500 of them in the history of the 63-year history of the song contest. So I'm getting there, but I've got a long way to go. Berke Yilmaz says, please play Every Way That I Can, the 2003 winner. That was winner for Turkey. Turkey 2003. Helen Karalyova says, it's unbelievable. How do you remember in which year which song won? Thank you. Some people would say it's a medical condition I've got, but I don't really want to be cured of it. I do like the Eurovision Song Contest, I have to say. And if a song is good, if the melody is good, then I remember it. Janet Goodman says, lovely hearing the piano. Lovely hearing the piano is very emotive. I did request Brotherhood of Man, Save All Your Kisses for Me. Thank you. was Brotherhood of Man that won for the United Kingdom in 1976. Karen Bird also wanted Brotherhood of Man. Save Your Kisses for Me. I hope you like that too. Verón Palmer, please, please play Volare. Not very good at Volare. It didn't win the Eurovision Song Contest, but it actually is one of the most famous songs to have come out of the contest. It was something like... Something like that, wasn't it? A very famous song. Of course, there are so many great Eurovision songs which never won the contest. Here's one, actually, of my favourites. It was Eres Tú that I think came third in 1973, but I think it's one of the best songs ever to have come out of Eurovision. That was Eres Tú for Spain in 1973. I think it came third. Frankie Mary, Nono l'età, Giuliola Cinquetta, 1964. That is absolutely right. Here's a little bit of that. '64 was a great year for the Eurovision Song Contest. That was a nice winning song. Matt Munro came second that year for the United Kingdom with I Love the Little Things. And Udo Jürgens for Austria came sixth, I think, with another great song. Udo Jürgens, one of the classics, one of the great legends of the Eurovision Song Contest. Leif Hoff would like Hallelujah, the Israeli winner, in 1979. Brady winner from 1979. And look who's just walked in to his own living room. I should say hello and introduce you to the Portuguese ambassador. Hello.
How are you? Good to see you.
It's great. I must thank this man. I feel I should stand up, but then I'm playing the piano, so I don't know what to do.
No, you're fine.
Thank you so much for allowing us into your home and to play your piano.
It's great that you are in Portuguese territory the first day of the Eurovision.
So we made it to Portugal after all.
You made it to Portugal for sure. You are like feel like yourself being in Lisbon.
Are you a fan of the Eurovision?
Yes, of course. I do have a special love for the Eurovision Song Contest. I think it's a fantastic event in terms of international relations, what we call people to people nowadays. And I'm very happy. And I was amazed because this was one of my favorite songs was Hallelujah.
Well, I'm glad I played it.
I came just in time to hear the Hallelujah.
It's so kind of you. With your permission, we'll stick around, and we've got lots more requests to get through.
That would be great.
I'm so grateful.
I'll be
grateful.
Listening to you as a big fan.
Good luck to Portugal this year.
Thank you. Let's see.
Thank you so much, Paolo. So let's go on with your requests. Ramsey Pietro Nassa would like Insieme from 1992. He says, no, Insieme, I think, was from 1990. No, let's see, 1990... Yes, 1990. That was Italy. Something like this, I think. The Italian winner in 1990, Insieme. Dima Adiev would like to hear Wild Dances. That was a winner for Ukraine in 2004, I think. Dances from Ukraine. Lots of love for a repeat of Lordy, requested by Amber Louise Firmage, Scott John Beale, Marco, Mikhail Tenkanen, Alice Webster, who says it would be amazing to hear Lordy on the piano. I did play that a bit earlier. You can go back a bit later and see that. We'll see if we've got time at the end for that. Let's see. Vinod Singh says, my all-time favourite, Abani B, Itzhak Cohen, 1978. That was the first victory for Israel. Something like this. A little bit of Israel from 1978. Carol Bevitt, please play Let It Swing by Bobby Sox. That was a winner for Norway in 1985, I think. Bobby Sox from 1985. Martin Cooper would like Molitva, a personal favourite. Yes, I haven't played it yet. That's that was a victory for Serbia in 2006. 2006? 2007. A little bit of Molitva for Serbia. Catherine Vallejo Vega says, thank you so much for this great fun, and my three-year-old is enthralled. Great. I hope your three-year-old becomes a fan of the Eurovision Song Contest. Ian Birkin writes, thank you for this. I'm really enjoying it. It's bringing back a lot of memories. That's the idea. I'm really glad. We're walking down Eurovision memory lane today. John Roberts says, you are amazing. That's very kind of you. How about Diggy-Loo Diggy-Lay? Why not? Absolutely. That was Sweden's victory in 1984. I don't know what diggy-loo diggy-lay means, but then I don't know what ding-ding-a-dong or boom-bang-a-bang really mean. So, let's go on. Andrew, I hope I can pronounce this correctly. Andrew Hassaya would like Merci Cherie by Austria, 1966. Yes, that was the great Udo Jürgens when he scored his win. One of my favourites too. Thank you. That was Austria's winning song from 1966. Let's see. Tor Rich would like Don Sivisa, Denmark, from 1963. That's going back a little bit. Let's see. Danish song, Don Sivisa. Manuel Batatinha would like Diva from Dana International, a winner for Israel in 1998. Israel, 1998, Dana International. Christy Kosmopoulou would like Secret Garden. That was the winner for Norway, I think, in 1995. Nocturne, I think the song was called, for Norway. Let's go on. Let's see. Francisco Vieira, please play Desfolhada by Simon de Oliveira. I don't know that one, I'm afraid. Let's see. Maxime van Ooijen would like Een Beetje, Netherlands, 1959. Let's see. That was something like... Netherlands back in 1959. Since we've got back to the 50s, let's remember the very first ever Eurovision winning song. It was for Switzerland. It was sung by Lise Assier, who passed away recently at the age of 94. It was called Refrain. This was the very first ever Eurovision winning song. was Refrain, the very first winning song for Eurovision. And, well, we've been going more than an hour now. I think it's probably time to stop very soon. I want to say a big thank you, first of all, to our cameraman, John Boone, to our producer, Will Vernon. A huge thank you to the Portuguese ambassador for letting us in to his home and to use the piano. And thank you to all of you for watching. And I just have one more piece of music. It's a tribute, really, to all the Eurovision songs that have taken part in this contest over the last 63 years. And basically, ABBA said it very well. Thank you for the music. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye from Moscow. Enjoy Eurovision. Thank you.